Okay, today is Tuesday, March 8th, 2016. I call the village board meeting in order. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Trustee Zarnik. Trustee Feichter.
Here.
Trustee Frankie.
Here.
Trustee Listener.
Here.
Trustee Petri.
Here.
Trustee Prochnow.
Here.
Everyone is here tonight. We do not have anyone for the invocation, so we'll do the Pledge Allegiance. Scouts, if you'll join us. Wait a minute.
Where's our flag?
Where's our flag?
Things are disappearing here.
Early voting?
Okay, Scouts, what do we do? How do we do the pledge if there's not a flag? There's your first question. What are we supposed to do? You have one on your shoulders? Okay. See? Be prepared. It came through. Okay, so, guys, you want to lead us on the Pledge Allegiance?
Start.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good job, guys. Have a seat. I like those shorts. That goes good with that.
Really good that they're here.
That goes good.
How will we do?
Scouts changed a little bit since I was in Boy Scouts. Okay, we will now move on to the approval of the minutes of February 23rd, 2016.
I move that we approve the minutes and dispense with the reading.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the record show unanimous approval. We now move on to the Mayor and Board of Trustees report. We do have one presentation tonight. Before we get to that, we've had a few items going on over the past couple weeks. On February 25th, Thursday, I had a tollway board meeting. Things are moving along very well with the tollway board and the work on the Elgin O'Hare. And the 90 work will be done before the end of this year. So that way, owns the whole route from Wisconsin to the Kennedy will go without any problems and should be very good and smooth sailing for everyone. On Thursday, Mr. Knickerbocker, March 3rd, I had my very first elevator safety review board meeting.
How fast did that go?
Longer than I thought, 2.5 hours.
Yeah, that's up.
But I tell you what was interesting about that. In case people don't know, the governor asked me to serve, as everyone knows, on the tollway board. He also asked me to serve on the elevator safety review board. It's a non-compensated board, meets 4 times a year, and actually don't always meet every time. My first meeting I went to. What they're looking at is very interesting. They're looking at elevators in, what do they call those?
Wind turbines.
Yeah. They didn't start installing elevators until 2006. In 2013, they came up with the guidelines for the safety and the rules for an elevator and wind turbine. We're now looking at how we handle the ones that were put in from 2006 to 2013. It was very interesting amount of wind turbines. It was 2.5, I mean, I actually learned a lot. It was very interesting. Do you realize by the year 2030, we should have enough wind turbine power to fully power 14.7 million homes? That's equivalent to all the homes in Ohio, Michigan, Indiana, and there's two other states. I mean, it's unbelievable. I mean, and give you a question. Where do you think the most wind turbines are? What state has the most wind turbines in this country?
Indiana.
Iowa.
Illinois.
Indiana.
Texas.
Oh, Texas.
That was close.
Second, Iowa.
Yeah,
New
Iowa.
Yeah, but basically Texas up to Oklahoma, Arkansas into Iowa, and the Dakotas have the most wind turbines. But I mean, it was very, I tell you, as much as I wasn't sure it was going to occur, it was very interesting listening about it. The average wind turbine, now the new ones they're building, are, what is it, 145 meters, so that's about 300, 400, it's like 50 stories tall. They're huge. They're huge. Yeah, and these things go. And the amount of gigawatts they put off, I'm telling you, it was very interesting. But so anyways, we are getting all the information, decided about elevators. But yeah, it's very interesting. I serve you another way, Mr. When you get on an elevator, Mr. Knickerbocker, you can be assured in Illinois it's going to be safe with me reviewing it for you.
If I get in a wind turbine, I'll feel the same.
You really feel safe. We'll put you on there and flim you off. So I had that on March 3rd. Also on March Third, we had the opportunity to meet with Senator Kirk's representatives. Our U.S. Senator here came in, was working with us on a number of issues. They're going to work with us on the airport issues and others. We appreciate them stopping by with us. And that night, we had the Elk Grove Chamber of Commerce had their beer and wine tasting event. I know most of the board was there that night. It was a very good event, went very well. And then last but not least, today, I had the opportunity, Mr. Trustee Petri, you met with the Salt Creek students here.
Right.
And they asked if I would stop by and visit them at the school. So I had a chance to go by and see them.
They didn't like what I did, I guess.
No, they enjoyed what you did. But see, they got pencils from you. They knew with me coming out something different, they got chocolates today.
Oh, okay.
So the kids were very happy, and I had a chance to go meet them at the Salt Creek School, so we enjoyed that. Also, I'd like to update a couple things. Tonight, you'll be seeing on our agenda, we're passing a $100,000, I wouldn't call it investment, a $100,000 limit. Budget limit to join with our neighbors in Schaumburg, Hanover Park, Roselle, and Itasca. Right now, ComEd's looking to put 170 foot tall. Pardon? 170 foot tall power lines along the Elgin O'Hare Expressway. Right now, it's geared toward the other side of the expressway, all the way out from Itasca to Hanover Park. And we have a lot of concerns, particularly the towns that are really right by it. And we're going to join with our neighbors in efforts to find ways to make it more compatible for the area, whether that means burying them or some other approach to it. So we're going to be working with our neighbor towns, and this money be used for experts, lobbyists potentially, and others to help us make sure that whatever is ultimately is done in a neighborhood communally friendly way. And we stand with our neighbors as we always do, and we look forward to work with them on that. Also last night, I know Trustee Lister joined me and our police department, Chief Schmidt, Chief Michael was there. Over at Stevenson School, we had a neighborhood meeting with a lot of neighborhood watch members. There's been a number of burglaries on the west side, and we wanted to update the residents in the area what's going on as much as we could talk about. We could not talk about everything, because our police are doing a phenomenal job. But we wanted people to know that there are multiple communities that will be infected by the same group of people. We have taken the lead on this. The other towns are following our lead on this. But it's happening from towns as far north as Lake Zurich, to as far south as Bolingbrook, as far west as Elgin, all the way past us to the east. So they're out there. What we're telling people, and we're telling people again tonight, is several things. One, if a young person should come to your door, ring the doorbell, and ask for a name, you have no idea who, and then leave, please call the police right away. Let them know that that's occurred. That's the way sometimes they want to check to see if everybody's home. One thing we do know is they do not want to run into people, so they check to make sure homes are empty and stuff. So make sure if the doorbell rings, answer the door, or at least go to the door, let them know that you're there. If you should see people you don't recognize in the neighborhood, cars you don't recognize in the neighborhood, please call the police. We want you to call the police. You're not going to bother us or upset us if it turns out to be a neighbor or someone that should be there. That's fine with us. We want to be aware of it. The main area that there have been located lately is over by the Stevenson School area, over there on the west side of the village. So if you're anywhere in the village, always be vigilant. Keep lights on, both inside and out at night. Pay attention to strangers in the area. If you're not sure about something, call 911. We want you to do that. Our police have stepped up enforcement. We're watching. We feel confident that as things happened before, as this time, we'll be confident we can catch them. The good news for people in the villages, they do not want to run into people. They don't want to find anybody. So I will not worry about someone coming after you physically. They're looking for vacant homes or unoccupied homes. That's what they're looking for. So it was very well. We had, I know Trustee Liston called, we had over 325 people there. It was a great turnout, and we appreciate the opportunity. So rest assured, our police on top of it. We had 35 officers come in for a meeting yesterday from different towns working on a task force. We actually have the FBI involved also for some technical advice. So we're doing the best we can. The other thing we'd like to point out here, we had our chief, Deputy Chief Walsh put together, in 2012, there was 113 burglaries in Elk Grove. In 2013, 91. In 2014, there was 49. Last year, we had 42. Most of the burglaries are occurring in our industrial park. A lot of times, they're employees at a place. After people leave, stick around or come back, rob things. We don't have that many on the residential side. But two things I want to point out. One, most of our burglaries are occurring in industrial park, but they do some in residential. But two, they have dropped dramatically due to efforts of our police department and changes with people, with cameras, and other security things. They have dropped off dramatically over the past 4 years, and they continue to drop. But we're always vigilant. I got to tell you, we've got probably the finest police department, bar none, in the country. They're on top of things. They have broken things like this before. They've cracked the cases before. And I think they're going to be very successful this time on it, too. So you can rest assured you got the best people working on your behalf. But again, please be vigilant. Watch your neighbor's house. Keep an eye out for your neighbor. And watch for strange cars and strange people in the neighborhoods. If you see them, don't hesitate to call. We're there to help you. We're glad to follow up with you. On that, the last thing I want to talk about tonight, Trustee Listener?
I just wanted to add one thing. I don't think you said this, but if you give access to the internet, if you check the Elk Grove website,
yes,
they're keeping a lot of updated information on there. Whether you live on the west side or east side, it doesn't matter. It's good information. So you may want to keep an eye on that. And if you have Channel 6, twice a day we have Elk Grove News, which we repeat a lot of stuff that's on the website for those people that don't go to the web. So if you, I think it's at 2 o'clock and 6 o'clock.
Right. You know. And the website is elkgrove.org.
Correct.
www.elkgrove.org. So thank if you get a chance, yeah, definitely make sure you check that stuff. And again, we'll keep you as informed as you can. There's some things we cannot talk about because we want to have the chance to catch these folks. But we're on top of it for you. And if you got questions and if you're not sure, call the police department. They're more than happy to talk to you. And we'll be glad to give you information we can. Last thing I want to bring up, Mr. Sammarco, on this beautiful, warm day, great information recently given out to us on this recent winter and snowfall. Up to this point, we've had 30 inches of snow, which is actually a little below average. Remember, 12 inches fell in the one snowstorm back in November. So since then, we've actually been below normal on snowfall. We've had less snowplow operations, obviously, this year than in the past, last year. And we're down about 7,800 tons of salt use compared to last year. So the winter so far, it's not over yet, but so far we've done well. And Vito, when we have had to use you folks, you've done a great job as usual. Let you guys know we appreciate the fine job. We've had some tough ones that 12 hours or 14 hours of ice coming down and stuff like that, but let you guys know they did another great job this year, and we thank them for a snow season we got through pretty safe and sound. So thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. With that, last but not least, we've got a special night. I'd like to invite Rita Sayer and Beth Thompson, I'm sorry, to come on up if they could. As people may or may not know, I still can't believe this.
Wait, okay, you can hear. I might leave after my report.
Do you want to say something?
Pardon? Do you want to say something? Give you that.
You
could do that.
Here's what's going on and how well you're doing stuff. But I know it's a little early, but what we're thinking about now is it's time for a nice team, things going. But every year, we're hoping you're going to be
what do you think's best?
Hi everyone, my name is Beth Thompson. I actually work for the American Cancer Society, so I work with VIDA and the Elk Grove Village event. So we wanted to thank the Elk Grove Village community today because in 2015, we all surpassed an amazing milestone. So the Elk Grove Village community has raised over $2 million in the fight against cancer with the American Cancer Society. So we wanted to thank you guys.
So we would be wrong.
I'd like to present a Elk Grove Village resist sign indicating no Dunleavy. And then they also have our certificate here. And the next flight is going to be held on June 11th. It's going to be again 11 p.m. Okay. So in my opinion, as I know when it first started, it was, oh, it was hold for. I'll let you hold that. And you know, I haven't read it yet, but I'm going to have you hold the proclamation in a second. Oh, yeah.
Just stand right up. There we go. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Good.
So it's going to be held on June 11th at the high school. So it'll be 11 a.m.
11 a.m. to 11 p.m. And I'm happy to report that we are having an amazing start to our event. We have over 300 people registered, and they were registered by Thanksgiving, incredibly early this year. And the efforts were full company. We issued a challenge to dress like a turkey and jump in the pool. We had 300 people registered by Thanksgiving. We made it, and we did an awesome job in the pool. We also raised already $15,000 toward our goal of $50,000. And we have over 30 teams, so it's one of the best starts ever in my involvement with Relay for Life. So thank you so much. Thank you, Mayor Johnson. Thank you, all of you, for participating for so many years. We really appreciate your support very much.
So what's nice is every year we come, we all come collect the money.
Yes.
And we have our sticky fingers, so it works out well. But I think it's come a long way. I mean, and I like 11 a.m. It works out well because people can come and go there and they want to, and it works out nice for them involved. It really is a special day. And if you've never been to one, you got to go. It is a lot of fun. The kids are having fun. The survivor walk is always a very special time. And everyone's been touched by cancer, someone they know or someone in the family. There's a coach at Elko that's been through this.
I only wish there was a community without cancer. One of the things that people don't know is the money we raise actually stays in the Chicago area. The money for research funds programs that are within 20 miles of here. You don't have to go very far. And the money that is spent on patient care services, actually I believe over 300 people in the last year from this area.
Oak Grove, Des Plaines, and Arlington Heights.
Sorry.
Called the American Cancer Society for help. So everything we raise stays here, and that's really nice. So thank you so much.
And show how far we've come. When it first started, it was Elk Grove, Des Plaines. But Elk Grove has done such a great job. We went on being just our own location.
Right.
And it's done well, and it's really come a long way. I never forget when they first came to me with the whole idea. I'm going, who would do something like this, walk and all this? And I'll tell you, it proved me wrong. It's really taken off. It's successful.
Good.
And we can't thank you enough, because you're right. It affects all of us. And it's something that hopefully someday won't be there anymore. Madison's making big leaps and bounds. I'm not sure if you heard former President Carter with that new type of treatment where your own immune system is battling, is cancer-free announced. And that is really exciting.
Astounding.
Yeah, that can happen. So, one last thing. We'd like to give you a special proclamation today. And it says, whereas more than 14 million living Americans have a history of cancer, which ranks second among leading causes of death in the United States, and whereas the American Cancer Society is the nationwide community-based volunteer health organization dedicated to eliminating cancer as a major health problem by preventing cancer, saving lives, and diminishing suffering from cancer through research, education, advocacy, and service. And whereas on June 11, 2016, the residents of Elk Grove Village and the local chapter of the American Cancer Society were joined forces with thousands of communities across the country and presented the 20th annual Relay for Life in Elk Grove Village, a community event to fight cancer. And whereas those who have advanced the cause against cancer fighting through their own fights with the disease, which will track a true survivor lab, and luminaries that will be lit in honor of those battling the disease and in memory of those who lost the battle. And whereas the Relay for Life in Elk Grove Village has raised over $2 million in the past 19 years for the American Cancer Society and Cancer Research. Now, therefore, I, Craig B. Johnson, Mayor of the Village of Elk Grove Village, do hereby proclaim June 11th, 2016, as Relay for Life Day in Elk Grove Village, Illinois, in recognition of those individuals facing the challenges of cancer with courage, confidence, and determination. Day this March 8th, 2016.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Before you go, now, I've read this more than one place, so I think it's true. But they say dark chocolate does help with some types of cancers. They do say that.
I've read it.
So,
I'm a believer, too.
Every day I'm a believer. So I've got some nice dark chocolate logos
much.
For you here. Don't worry, Scott. You do a good job. I won't forget you. And some for you.
Thank you.
And we
thank
do
you
thank you
much.
For your
thank
efforts.
You
and Rita, thank you
much.
For what you're doing. We appreciate
right.
it. We'll see you on June 11th.
Right. Bye-bye.
Thanks a lot. Give him a hand for a fine effort. Okay, let's see. Scout there, first one. How much money have we raised?
$2 million.
Ah, you're gonna lose your chuck. How much have we raised? You guys there? Over how much? He said $3 million. That's not right.
I said $2 million.
Oh, you said two?
Yeah.
My bad. I'm getting old. Bad years.
You're mayor for a day.
There you go.
Ready? I know.
Yep. You play baseball?
Yes.
Okay, you sure?
Yes.
Oh. That's football.
You got it right. My bad. I didn't hear you.
I got it.
Okay. That concludes the mayor's report. And move on now to trustee's report. Trustee Jeffrey Charles Franke.
No report.
Trustee Listener.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I was just looking something up, and I don't have it yet, but I did early vote today, and I was just checking the county clerk's website, and the count for Elk Grove is up to 796, which is quite a bit over even yesterday. So I'm not sure what the normal is for Elk Grove, but looks like there's a good 100 or so plus every day. So
it's a little higher than normal.
A lot higher than normal? Oh, good. So I'm not telling you who I voted for, but unless you really ask me. And that concludes my report. Mr.
Well, I know on Saturday, I went with Lori and Megan, and they had a good business, good steady line on Saturday. Quite a few people they said were going through. So it's nice because that was the first time Megan ever voted in the presidential election. And another young lady who's 19, that's the first time she ever got a chance to vote. And they're like too little excited. No, they are kids, but they're so excited, both of them, they get a chance to vote. It's nice to see that. It's nice to see the young people doing it.
Sure. Is it till 5 o'clock on Saturday?
Yes. Yep.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yep. And are they open on Monday too?
Yes.
That's
yes.
what I thought.
They go through Monday, March 14th at 5 p.m.
That's great. Again, Judy, I can't thank you enough. That is so popular, that early voting. And not just for presidential. We do it for local elections, all the rest. Thank you, because I know they love, all the judges love coming to Elk Grove. And you and your staff and Donna, you guys did a great job. Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you.
We appreciate having that. Okay, thank you, Trustee Lister. Trustee Petri.
I just want to welcome our attorney, George Knickerbocker, back from his brief hiatus, and also recognize Mr. Petzold for being here again, our most famous observer.
Now, wait a minute. You said welcome back, Mr. Knickerbocker. That's not what you were saying at the last board meeting.
Well, he's making up. We change when they're here.
We are glad to have Mr. Knickerbocker back. Mr. Knickerbocker had a little work done, a little surgery, so his voice is off a little bit, but you're feeling good?
I do, and you like my voice.
I like your voice a lot.
Yeah, I know.
And I don't have to pay for it. I like it even better.
Make me an offer.
Okay. Trustee Zarnik.
Thank you. I also got a chance to vote early, and in fact, yesterday I had a meeting, and some ladies came in after 5 o'clock, and we had to explain to them that was from 9 to 5, so it is something that people are really taking advantage of, which is great. Just wanted to announce again that the applications for the Frank Zarnik scholarships are available at the high schools. There's 6 $1,000 grants for Elk Grove residents. The cutoff date is April 22nd, so remember to apply for the possibility of assisting you with your college expenses. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, Trustee Zarnik. And last but definitely not least, Trustee Pecknell.
Thank you. Just two things I want to announce tonight. I want to remind everybody that we still have the 60th anniversary car raffle.
Castle Chevrolet has generously donated a 2016 Chevy Camaro that will be raffled off as part of our 60th anniversary, and one lucky driver will drive away with a brand new Camaro. Raffle tickets are $5 each, or $5 for $20. All proceeds from the raffle go to community organizations that serve the residents of Elk Grove Village. And on July 4th, 2016, six finalists will receive $600 and a key. Then at the 60th anniversary evening concert on Sunday, July 17th, one of the keys will start the car determining the ultimate winner. The Camaro is being donated by Castle Chevrolet. You can buy your tickets online. We will have the Camaro on display at some of our special events before the 4th of July, but you can also buy your tickets online at www.2016CamaroRaffle.com. The Rotary Club has generously helped us with the facilitation of this raffle, so we thank them for their efforts. And the second thing I wanted to announce is that we have the Lioness Club has the Elk Grove Betty Erickson Memorial Scholarship. This year we will be giving two $1,000 scholarships in memory of Betty Erickson, a longtime Lioness Club membership. This is open to Elk Grove seniors, and they should be demonstrating outstanding leadership, community participation, and service to the community. Applications are available at Conant High School, St. Viator High School, and Elk Grove High School. So anyone that has any questions can contact me. The deadline for this application is April 1st, 2016. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, Trustee Procknell. Next, we move on now to the accounts payable warrant. We'll first do February 29th, 2016.
I move that we pay bills in the accounts payable warrant for February 29th, the amount of $1,775,041.60.
Second.
We have a motion by Trustee Petri, and a second by Trustee Zarnik. Judy, can you call the roll, please?
Trustee Frankie?
Aye.
Trustee Listener?
Aye.
Trustee Petri?
Aye.
Trustee Procknow?
Aye.
Trustee Zarnik?
Aye.
Motion passes 5-0. Accounts payable warrant for March 8th, 2016.
I move that we pay bills in the accounts payable warrant for March 8th in the amount of $977,778.18.
Second.
We have a motion by Trustee Petri, second by Trustee Zarnik. Scouts, you know, that's going to be a question how much you just approved. To the penny. And no objection, record the votes, please demonstrate it 5-0. Tonight we have consent agenda items A as in Mr. Raspy Voice, A as in what?
Archery.
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 Wow, that's like out of nowhere. I like that. That's good. Through J as in?
Javelin.
What do you think, Olympics, Summer Olympics?
It's coming up.
Where are they going to be held at?
Reno.
All right. Rio de Janeiro.
Yes.
Number you zero. You going to them?
I don't think so.
No?
I didn't make the team.
Okay, so tonight we have consent agenda items A as in archery through J as in javelin. Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Trustee Frankie, second by Trustee Zarnik. And trustees or staff, everything to add on the consent agenda?
Just one item on the item B on the concrete program. We were able to come up with an additional $45,000 because the bids were low, and we'll do some additional concrete repair throughout the village.
And that mostly go for sidewalks, right?
Right.
That's great.
Could I ask a question about that?
Trustee Procknow?
I talked to a resident earlier today who mentioned we normally participate in the concrete replacement program with our residents. Are we no longer doing that?
We didn't last year because of the concrete shortage, because of the tollway.
Right.
And you can play that on Craig.
So are we not participating?
We had a two-year hiatus.
Yeah.
Okay. We're trying to wait for the concrete
next year
prices
we'll be
to come
back.
Down.
And, okay, that's what I was trying to explain, but I wanted to verify that was true. That, so we're not participating this year with the residents.
We hadn't planned on the program this year.
Okay, thank you.
And don't blame just me. There's eight other ones up there.
I blame me for not doing it last year while I procrastinated, and now I'm really in trouble.
Well, also the elevators that lift the concrete, he's in charge of those too. So.
And the windmill will get the wind to dry
exactly.
It out fast. So, okay, anybody in the audience want to talk about the consent agenda tonight? No? Remember that dollar amount, Scouts. See if you got it. Okay, and without objection, record the votes, please demonstrate it. 5-0. No items of regular agenda. Capital Improvements Committee, Trustee Petri.
Just that we have been making some progress on some of our projects because of the nice weather, and hopefully we'll start in earnest in another couple of weeks.
Okay. That it?
That's all.
Okay. Judiciary Planning and Zoning Committee, Trustee Listener.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The JPZ committee met this afternoon to discuss a consolidation of four separate lots and a vacated alley into one lot to build a Dunkin' Donuts. That's at 2750 Tui, which is right at Elmer's Road, across from the Tank Farm. Anyway, the plans had been previously approved by the Plan Commission, and village staff have approved it, and our village code requires that the planning, or that the JPZ committee review it before it goes to the village board. And it was approved unanimously, so if we could take steps to put it on the next meeting agenda, I think that would be appropriate.
Yep.
And that concludes my report.
And we'll take care of that as noted. Thank you, Trustee Lister. Personnel Committee, Trustee Frankie.
Yes, there's still a few openings left for our summer seasonal positions. You need to be a high school graduate and enrolled in college to apply. It's a starting rate of $11.51 an hour, and you work 10 weeks during the summer. So if you're interested, please go to the village website and look under job applications, download it, and send it in. Normally, these jobs go pretty quick, so if you're interested, don't delay. And Elk Grove residents are preferred, but if we don't get enough of those, we'll take someone else. But it's great. You make over $5,000 for the summer. It's great spending money for school. So if you get a chance, apply for the job, and hopefully you get it. That's all I have.
Thank you. Information committee. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Mr. Nickerbocker. Recycling and Waste Committee, filling in for Trustee Feister tonight, is Trustee Prochnow.
Trustee Feister asked me to remind everybody that if you have Christmas lights that are no longer working, we are still accepting them through the end of March for recycling at Village Hall. And that concludes my report.
Got the way you
do that.
If he watches this, he's going to be so mad at me.
From now on, you give his report.
Not only concise, as our real attorney said, but also very, I would say, emotional with her.
You say real.
I have a great passion for recycling.
Not Noah. Attorney Payne, the backup to Noah. Very good. Thank you, Trustee Prochnow.
You're very welcome.
Now we move on to Information Committee, Trustee Prochnow.
No report.
Cable Television Committee, that dynamic duo of Trustee Lister and Petri. Are you having a sidebar?
We're having a meeting.
Yes, we are.
I just want to mention that we heard this evening that AT&T, UVerse, will be providing Channel 6 to their customers by the end of this month.
Yep. End of March.
Actually, Elk Grove Television, they won't be providing
Channel 6. It'll be Elk Grove Television. It'll be on Channel 99, I guess. But anyway, we hope you enjoy it, and thank you for keeping us working on that. And that concludes our report.
Thank you for your patience. See, even a blind squirrel finds a nut once in a while. Right. So we got it. Business Leaders Forum, Justin Lister and Petri.
Just a reminder that we have a BLF meeting on March 17th, Thursday at 11 o'clock in Room E.
I also wanted to add, Mr. Mayor, that Trustee Zarnik and Prochnow, and I think Trustee Frankie will be doing it shortly, have been mentioning the availability of college scholarships. There's a group that Elk Grove's involved with called the Golden Quarter Advanced Manufacturing Partnership. The acronym is GCAMP. Anyway, they're holding a internship and career fair on Wednesday, April 13th at the Amada America. It's a big company in Schaumburg. It'll be from 3 to 6 p.m. And if you're a junior or a graduating senior from local high schools, you may want to consider going to that if you're not going to pursue college at this time. Jim and I have been mentioning through the Business Leadership Forum that one of the big items we keep hearing from a lot of the manufacturers is they have a lot of skilled jobs that don't require a college degree per se, but they do need work in this advanced manufacturing type field. So. Thanks to Ross, so I don't have to repeat this all. It's right on the screen for those people that are looking at Channel 6 right now. And the two register, just call 847-815-6729. The person that heads it up is Gary Skoog, is that correct, Ray? Gary Skoog. He also has a web email, it's gskoog1@gmail.com. Anyway, that's April 13th, and if you need any information, you could just call the village, and I'm sure we could pass it on. And that concludes our report.
Thank you. Youth Committee, Trustee Jeffrey Charles Flanke.
On the same page with the scholarships, the Youth Committee and the Parks Foundation have three $1,000 scholarships that are available, two through the village, one through the Parks Foundation. You need to be a senior in high school. You could be an Elk Grove resident. You can go to Viters, Conant. You can check at any of the schools for the application, plus our website or the Park District website. Get the application, fill it in, make sure you get it in. I'll make sure I got the date right this time. Needs to be in by May 6th, not March, May 6th. And we will announce the winners at the end of May. But please get those in early. Don't wait till the last minute. So we will cut it off on May 6th.
Just a comment, and I should have mentioned it during mine, but we also accept applications from homeschool children, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
All of us.
As long as you're an Elk Grove resident.
Yes.
And you're going on to college because the money will be, the check will be cut.
Or trade school.
Or trade school, beauty school, trade school, yeah. Anything like that. Continuing education. How's that?
Got it.
We'll use that as a term. So please get those forms filled out, and they're also on our website. So please take a look there and download them, get them in. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Parade Committee, Trustee Zarnik.
You're not going to turn? Oh, thank you, George.
No, that.
The 60th birthday parade is Saturday, June 18th, 5 p.m. We're celebrating yesterday, today, and tomorrow. We have six couples who will be celebrating their 60th anniversaries along with us. So for the next six board meetings, I'll announce one. The first is Donald and Rosemary Kauth. They were married October 13th, 1956. They moved into their first home on Lilac Lane in 1959 and are now living in their third home in Elk Grove Village. They've raised four sons, one of which has chosen Elk Grove to raise his three sons. And it continues with one of his sons getting married and buying a house here. So there are three generations. What a wonderful tribute to our exceptional community. That's one of our grand marshals. Our next parade meeting is Monday, April 4th at 5:30 p.m. And that concludes my report.
Thank you. Now we move on to health and community services. Trustee Zarnik.
The Caring Place is a socialization program for adults. It's organized and supervised by trained personnel. The program is available on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 9:30 a.m. till 3:30 p.m. at Christus Victor Church. There's room for more. It's a wonderful help for caregivers to get a respite, to know that their loved ones are having a good time. If you're interested, please call 847-890-5334. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, Trustee Zarnik. There's no report under Liquor Commission tonight. Special events, the next one is, of course, the Memorial Day celebration, which will be held, that's what, 10:45? 10:45 on Memorial Day. Inside, so rain or shine, hot or cold, you'll be comfortable and looking forward to it. Chief Schmidt, are guys ready with the guns? Okay, good. Gotta be a little loud in those caps, though, don't they? Or?
That's okay. It makes.
Was that good enough?
It adds to the, yeah.
So they're okay?
They were fine with everything last year.
Okay, just want to make sure.
Yes.
Okay. So looking forward to that. Midsummer Concert Classic Series, Mr. Knickerbocker. So who do we start off with on July 4th?
I keep on missing this one.
Peter Cetera.
There's a big city that's right near us.
Oh, yeah, Peter Cetera.
Peter Cetera, thank you. Chicago. Matter of fact, he's going to be inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame very shortly.
Yes.
Our second concert, which will be here. Now, the first one's at Park LGK, along with fireworks. The second one's at the Town Center here. And that will be?
Leanne Rimes,
very good.
This is tough.
Our third one, which will be our 60th anniversary. On January 17th, again over Park LGK with the fireworks. That will be
Foreigner.
And that, of course, comes after our community picnic.
Yes, it does.
Which will be out at the town center here for all the young people and the families. And then our last concert, which will be out here, will have...
How am I doing so far?
Well, with Trustee Petry helping, you're doing good.
Just a little. Michael McDonald.
See? He helped you again.
From Doobie Brothers.
See, I don't even see your lips move when he talks. He does a good job.
I've been practicing.
Right. Michael McDonald, formerly of the Doobie Brothers.
Yes.
So we have four big shows. And don't tell Mr. Knickerbocker, what was the last time? Who's doing our tree lighting concert this year? Don't tell him.
Oh, I know that.
And that is?
Buckinghams.
The Buckinghams. Okay. That's right. So we got quite a lineup coming up, right, Mr. Knickerbocker?
Yes, indeed.
So are you going to be there?
No.
I'm not a guest singer. I know that.
No, I know that, too. So, but it should be a good show. We're looking forward to it. So with this warm weather, we're starting to think more about summer and the warm weather coming, and we look forward to everyone being there for that. Airport update. I believe the ONCC has a meeting, the O'Hare Noise Compatibility Commission, on Friday. Our hope is that they will continue to work with us and allow the FAA, City of Chicago, come up with different flight paths so we can compare them over the summer. And they try different fly quiet programs, rotation-wise and all the rest, and we look forward to that going forward. Again, our group, JDA, is working very closely with Chicago and the FAA, and our hope is everything comes out very well for us on that. Mr. Rummel, there's nothing on the zoning board or plan commission?
That is correct, and I'll forego my report this evening.
No El Nino?
No El Nino.
I covered that already?
Oh, the weather's beautiful.
That's right. It's gorgeous out there. Okay. Judy, besides doing a great job with early voting, anything else tonight?
No, nothing. We went over it earlier.
Okay. Thank you. There's no unfinished business, no new business. Before we go to, trustees, you have anything to add tonight? Before we go to public comment, scouts, so how much did we approve on our consent agenda warrant for March 8th, 2016? Did anybody write that down? You did? Okay, how much was it? Hang on. Go ahead. Gotta speak louder, I couldn't hear him. No, that's Mr. Nickbach's paycheck. Did anybody get it? Okay, I'll get you some other questions in a second. Let me think here. What troop are you guys from? And do we have different troops here? Okay, where are you guys located out of? Okay, but is there a church or? Okay, right over here on Beisner? Okay, so are you guys all from Elk Grove or other towns? Elk Grove? How many guys are in high school? You two? Three? Elk Grove High School? Conan? Okay, so the west side or east side can go to that Boy Scout troop. Okay. The rest of you guys, what, in junior high?
Sixth grade.
Not yet.
Oh, so west side, you still go to the middle, or you're still in grade school?
Yeah.
Which one, Stevenson or Link?
Stevenson, Link. So, like, different schools.
Okay.
So
that's different. It doesn't have the whole troop, basically a West Side residents over on the east side at Baptist. Has that always been that way? Or is there other scouts from this side of the village too?
There are scouts from the east side also.
Okay, so it's a whole community.
He probably knows the history better.
Okay, so there's history. So is this the troop you're involved with,
Yes, Chief? Traditionally this troop is out of Link and Stevenson, but we have had students from the east side come up and work on the east side come up.
Okay. Yes. So what, Cub Scouts in what, at fifth grade? Yes. And then Boy Scouts is junior high or middle school and then high school?
Starting
with Okay. So you guys are here for citizenship badge, right?
Yes.
Okay. Let me ask you this. How old do you have to be to vote?
18.
Very good. Okay. Any of you guys 18 yet? No? Well, high school kids can be 18. Scouts can be 18.
They can be, if they're 18 by November, mm-hmm. They can vote in primary.
Okay. So no one's there yet. Okay. So that's first. Very good. Got that one right. How long of a term is a village trustee? How many years? How long of a term is a trustee? How many years? Like the President of the United States, a 4-year term. A congressman's a 2-year term. A U.S. Senator, a 6-year term. How long of a term is a village trustee?
Four.
Very good. How long of a term is the mayor?
Four.
No, it's lifetime. I'm joking. It's a four-year term also. I just kidding. Yeah, Tom Robbins fell out of his chair. So, very good. So you got that right. Okay. I'm going to do something different. Trustee Frankie.
Oh, great.
You ask a question.
Why?
Does he want to throw it?
That's the question. Why? No. I don't.
What's the question about government?
I don't know anything about it.
Okay, I'll ask another question. The village clerk, in some towns, they're elected, and in some towns, they're appointed. Elk Grove's village clerk, who does a phenomenal job, Ms. Keegan, is she elected or appointed? Pardon? Very good. Boy, you're on top of this stuff.
I do have a question now. I have a question for him.
Oh, I thought you said it. I'm sorry.
Three of us said.
Is that okay? I'm fresh. All right, Trustee Frankie does have a question.
I do. Who has been the youngest trustee and best looking on this board?
That's a tough one.
Well, I started me.
Ty.
There's our next trustee right there. Good politician.
You guys did good. We're gonna get you out by 8 o'clock. We're going to get you going fast. First off, we thank you for coming tonight. We appreciate it. Hopefully you saw a little bit how government is. Because of all the government you work with, local government's the one that affects you the most. Okay, I just met with the Salt Creek kids today. I talk about this. Let me real quick with you. What's the first thing you guys do in the morning when you wake up?
Go to bed.
What's first thing?
Get out of bed.
Get out of bed, okay. What do you do right after you get out of bed?
Put our clothes on.
Put on clothes. What do you do next? Okay.
That's a good goal.
What do you do next? What do you do when you get up? Yeah. You got to say it a little loud. After you go eat breakfast, what do you do after that?
I brush my teeth.
Well, stop there. You brush your teeth pretty quick, right? What do you use when you brush your teeth?
What? After breakfast.
Huh? No, what do you use? When you brush your teeth, what do you use? A toothbrush, what else?
Toothpaste.
And what else?
Water.
Very good. Who's responsible to bring you water?
The Elk Grove Village.
That's right. Now, do you take a bus or you drive to school? Or do you get driven to school or do you take a bus to school? You walk? What do you walk on?
Sidewalk.
Who's responsible to put those sidewalks in?
Elk Grove Village.
That's right. When your parents drove you here tonight, or your dad, whoever drove you here tonight, what'd you ride on?
In the car.
And what'd the car ride on?
Road.
Who's responsible for the roads?
Elk Grove Village.
That's right. If you have a problem, you get hurt, injured, bleeding, need emergency help, who do you call? And who comes?
Richard J. Michael.
Very good.
Every call he goes on.
The fire department comes. Who's responsible for the fire department? That's right. If you're scared, or like we have the recent break-ins over there, and you see someone you don't recognize, who do you call to come check on them?
The police.
Who's responsible for the police? That's right. And when we had the snowstorm back in November, 12 inches, cars couldn't get through the streets or anything like that. How did they get cleaned up? And who does that? That's right. So who do you think probably affects your life the most of all the governments? President Obama and the federal government? Governor Round in the state? Cook County President Preckwinkle? Or the village?
Village.
That's right. Yet, you know when the lowest voter turnout occurs? In the village elections. Our last election, I think we had like 2.5% of people voted. Come November in the presidential election, we could be as high as 80%. And I guarantee the President of the United States probably has no idea where Elk Grove is, has no clue if you have water or not, or if you got streets, nothing. But 80% of the people will vote for that. Governor election, you sometimes get 40 to 50%. County, maybe 30, 35. But for your village government, if we have 5% turnout, that's a good election year. It's pretty sad, isn't it? And you just proved the point that almost everything you do when you're awake we have some impact on in your life, from the roads to the water to police to fire, public works, everything you do, yet no one remembers. So if you learn anything during your civics badge, learn that your local government is the most important government that's out there. And here's the amazing thing. Was anybody there last night at the Stevenson? Was anything happening? No? You're there last, you folks were there? What number did I give out last night? When I got up and spoke, what phone number did I give out? Remember I gave out a phone number? No? Do you remember, sir? I gave out my phone number. I guarantee you President Obama would not come before a group and give out his personal phone number. Governor Rowland won't give it out, but your local mayor will. So if you learn anything during this, it's your local people, your local officials that help you the most, that are there for you the most, and it's the ones you should pay attention to the most. We're around for you. Fair enough? Because of that, when we're done here in about 2 minutes, come on down. I got something for each and every one of you. Fair enough? Okay, good job, guys. Does anybody else wish to address us tonight? Mr. Pet, yes? Was it bad?
No, it was good. I thought you did a really good job.
I think I'm on a roll lately. Last night I did a good job.
Last night he was good.
Mrs. Murphy was happy how I treated the kids at Salt Creek today.
About time he stepped it up.
Yeah, I'm not.
Mayor for life.
Something's going wrong.
Oh, I just one more thing.
Trustee Pecknell?
Just a reminder, mark your calendar. Sunday, July 17th is the actual 60th anniversary of Elk Grove Village. The Park District is also celebrating their 50th anniversary. We are having a huge celebration that day from 12 to 5 in the Village Square and at the Park District. The Park District is doing 50 events to celebrate the 50. The Village is doing a Village picnic. We'll be providing food and entertainment and a band and food at reduced prices. Very reduced prices. A lot of entertainment, a lot of games. We'll have a DJ, and we're going to have a giant slide. That's right. And we have a performance by the Hat Guys. And following that, in the evening at 7 o'clock, will be our big concert at near 7:30. So just keep that day open.
And where's that big concert at? It's at a park.
Park
LG. That's right. Okay.
Yeah.
Make sure. Okay,
Mr. Right a days into the high school.
Mr. Petzo, how do we do tonight?
Excellent for Tuesday.
You look very good, too, tonight, Mr. Petzo.
The Scouts did a good job tonight.
Didn't they do great? They sure did. Our future's in good hands with boys like that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I got to tell you, if you notice, Mr. Petzo, doesn't the world just seem a little smoother tonight now that both you and Mr. Knickerbocker are here?
Excellent.
It's just rotating very smoothly right now. I can't say enough, right, Mr. Knickerbocker? And I did miss you.
Well, you can't say enough?
I did miss you.
I'm still going on. Thank you.
No, I'm serious. I did. I said a prayer for your health, and I'm glad you're back. Well, good to have you here.
Thank you.
And I could say all that without my tongue falling off. Normally when I lie like that, my tongue flies off, but it didn't tonight. Well, glad you're back.
Thank you.
I'm glad you're feeling better.
I am.
Okay. Okay, with that, I need a motion to adjourn so the Scouts can get out of here. They're getting bored now.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Trustee Zarin, second by Trustee Frankie. Now, Scouts, just so you know, is Dairy Queen open yet?
Yes. Yeah.
Just so you know, normally, a good Scout leader, I was a Cub Scout master at Salt Creek School, and whenever I took my Cub Scouts to functions like this, I always stop by Dairy Queen with them afterwards. Now, my understanding, that's the unwritten rule of scouting. So my hope is that your scoutmasters remember you now that Dairy Queen's open and it's warm out. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, hold on one thing, though. Maybe the Scouts could say that the mayor should take us to go to Dairy Queen, the board. Since
I'm
going to
do even better for the board because I like them so much and we work so well together. I'm getting them all Jirage treats tonight. That's the kind of mayor I am. So with that said, nice green St. Patrick's Day celebration treats. With that said, Judy, can you call the roll, please?
Trustee Franke?
Aye.
Trustee Listener?
Aye.
Trustee Petri?
Aye.
Trustee Prochno?
Aye.
Trustee Zarnik?
Aye.
I had to make sure that Rob was open. I knew it wasn't like a week ago. I was going to check. With that said, Scouts, come down. I got something for you. Then enjoy Dairy Queen. And meeting adjourned.
There we have it.